Parikshit, my colleague is live with us right now. Parikshit, Meira Kumar once again requesting and appealing to listen to the voice of the soul, but that doesn't seem to be working with so much of divide and a large chunk of opposition actually going in favor of Ramnath Kovind.
Absolutely. So that divide is very much there. Meira Kumar trying to put a brave front on behalf of the opposition parties who are supporting her, that this is a fight for ideology. Nowhere she is saying that this is a fight for victory or this is a fight for fight to get all the votes together. They are focusing only on principle. They are focusing only on the issue of secularism, freedom of expression. They are actually trying to hit out at the Prime Minister and the government, saying that this is a government that has been tried, that trying to divide the people, trying to divide communities on the lines of ideology. There is no freedom of expression, and it's somehow their line, Meira Kumar's line, and that of the Congress resonates with their larger fight in Parliament. But will they be able to keep their flock together? It doesn't seem so. You've already seen cracks. The NCP is supporting Ramnath Kovind. Mulayam Singh Yadav, Shivpal Yadav, they are supporting Ramnath Kovind as well. So the cracks very much there. A lot of leaders not buying this theory of the Congress. And it also has to do with larger ambitions of these political parties for 2019. Do they see Congress as a strong alternative, or do they think that they need to keep a working relationship on with the government till the 2019 election? So it seems that the Congress may not have been able to keep their flock together. We just heard from Meira Kumar. She also took a question from us on what is this fight all about? What are the principles that she's fighting for? What is her appeal to the opposition? And she's saying that she wants to do away with the caste divide. She wants to do away with poverty. She wants to fight for secularism, the principles of the constitution. All in all, these are points that our sources have told us will be raised in the upcoming session of parliament. So they want to create a perception about this government, try and push them in a corner, but let's see how much of that opposition unity really works in Parliament. The fact that Gopal Krishna Gandhi has been put up as a candidate, and the fact that Shiv Sena and the likes of allies of the BJP are raising this point about his support for Yakub Memon and questioning that entire case, that is something that could be raised by other parties as well. Let's see how that plays out. We just heard from Meira Kumar. Her office had said that she will not take any more questions. She would only take about one or two questions and leave. We believe that she has an engagement for the day. She's going to be leaving her residence. But apart from that, no political meetings today.
All right, Parikshit. We've spoken about, we've discussed about reactions to Gopal Krishna Gandhi, how Shiv Sena has opposed him, and others are also coming out in opposition to Gopal Krishna Gandhi's candidature as the next vice presidential candidate for Congress and the opposition parties together. What are your sources telling you? How is the Congress party reacting to Venkaiya Naidu as his candidature for the vice presidential post, as he appears to be the front runner, although it has not been announced as yet, but our sources tell us that he could be one of the front runners. So how is the Congress party reacting to this name and other opposition as well? What are you getting?
Absolutely. Well, sources are saying the Congress is going to hit out at the government once this name is finalized. They are going to say that the government has chosen somebody from government, somebody who is a politician, somebody who is in line with the BJP RSS style of thinking. And look at Gopal Krishna Gandhi. He's somebody who has been in public service. He has impeccable credentials. He's not exactly a political person, just the way Venkaiya Naidu is. And that's why you need to have a non-political person for the post of vice president. This is the larger point that the Congress is going to make. They are going to hit out at the government over it once that name of Venkaiya Naidu is announced. But at the end of the day, we have seen, haven't we, Sheetal, over the years, over the past few decades, whichever government has been in power, it has had a greater say when it comes to the choice of the presidential candidate. You have seen that with the Pratibha Patil, you have seen that with Pranab Mukherjee, you have seen that with Mr. Hamid Ansari, who is the Vice President of India, and also with APJ Abdul Kalam.